Today marks the culmination in the building of the wonderful structure you see behind me, and we want to thank all of you for joining us to help celebrate this achievement.
The Vanguard School was created to be a different option, something out of the ordinary. When our school opened in 1995, charter schools were new and rare. I like to think that our approach and performance is unique, and I'm honored that our school has inspired and been used as the model for several other schools locally and around the state.
So the Vanguard School is a K through 12 charter. So we have kindergarten all the way through graduating seniors from high school. Our new junior high has 12 classrooms and 2 labs. The classrooms ring the perimeter and they're state of the art. We've got smart boards in there. Our labs are also outfitted with those same smart boards. They have fume hoods. They have student desks that have water, power, and gas running to them. So we are so excited about the instructional capability we have, certainly in the science department, but across the board in all areas.
It has been my sincere pleasure to be able to move into this new building and teach here because it's beautiful. I love the high ceilings, I love the paint, I love the carpet, I love the new teacher's lounge and the copy room. Like, everything is just so much nicer and easier to use.
We also made sure we had administrative space. There's room for our assistant principal's office, conference space. So we tried to make sure we thought through everything that this building would need to be completely self-contained and accommodate everything we would need in a junior high. And we think we've done a wonderful job working with all our partners to bring about a first-class instructional facility.
As we grew from starting our high school, we were investigating a more traditional approach, and we're not happy with the expected cost on that and began to look at other models. And at that point, looked at monolithic domes and liked the potential savings in the construction costs, but also we're very drawn to the long-term savings in the utilities and the overall durability of the building.
Often we're asked about what is it other than the obvious shape of the dome that makes a dome unique, and there's really three elements. One is freedom of design. Because the dome is a completely open free span structure, there's no interior supports or columns that have to be considered in designing the interior layout, so they have complete flexibility. Another one is its thermal efficiency. Because of the nature of the building itself and the materials that we use, we maintain a very tight structure that retains its heat and keeps, you know, unwanted heat or cold from coming in and out of the building. So they're tremendously efficient, often as much as 50%, 60% more efficient than traditional structures. And then finally, the resiliency of the building, meaning they can withstand an incredible amount of abuse, whether that's just the effects of time or UV or impacts from, you know, windborne debris, so in extreme weather events, for example. So that resiliency, and those are three really important aspects of concrete domes. For the Vanguard School, like every other customer or owner, project owner, there are considerations for cost and schedule, and then the overall design that people are concerned about. And in this case, it was no exception. In fact, they had a very accelerated schedule, and we owe a lot of thanks to just the whole team for collaborating, working together. Groundbreaking didn't start until the very end of 2016, and then by, you know, the end of third quarter 2017, the whole facility was done. So that was almost lightning speed in the construction world.
The dome was certainly a very unique project, the first one that I've been involved in. The dome itself is unique from an energy cost savings perspective. There are 6 energy recovery ventilators that circulate the air within the dome. Each classroom has its own fan coil unit and a fan in the center of each classroom that circulates air. Also, the lighting system is very robust. There is occupancy sensors, there's daylight harvesting, and a control system that controls the lighting that also ties into the HVAC. So we anticipate that there will be about a 50% energy savings over a traditional building.
Most of our contact was directly through Wayne Tamura. It was a great pleasure working with South Industries because all of the employees were extremely cooperative, very friendly, very professional, very open to inputs and tweaks and changes as the process goes, and honestly couldn't be more pleased with how that worked.
The dome itself, I think, is beautiful, really a striking structure here on our campus. And our teachers go in there and our students go in and they have a brand new teaching space that's larger, both width and length, but also a higher ceiling.
Research shows that space and aesthetics really make a difference in the learning, and this dome is evidence of that. I just noticed more of a calmness come over the students since being in the dome.
I don't know how they did it, but it's like the perfect size. So we've got plenty of space to walk in the hallways, but it's not so big that you can't get to your class. I don't know, it's perfect.
My daughter is absolutely thrilled to be in this new building. She has said it's kind of like starting the school year all over again. The building is amazing. It's just really something she's very proud of. When we drive by, she likes to point it out, and I think it's really kind of a nice landmark here in Colorado Springs.
So of course, we're here today for the ribbon cutting ceremony for the opening of the new junior high. And it's a great opportunity for us to do a little advertising and to talk about how well this project went, but also to talk a little bit about the future of the Vanguard School and what that means to our families and to our students, and get that message out across the Colorado Springs area.
Our students learn grammar, logic, and rhetoric such that they understand the great ideas that have shaped Western civilization. In doing so, they are prepared to engage with those ideas and to generate new ones as part of the great conversation. Thank you all again for being here to celebrate the completion and opening of this building, our dome.
There it is.